Hello everyone. Today we will study about the motion of a charged particle in uniform magnetic field. Right? We have already studied the formula for the magnetic force experienced by a charged particle. And for understanding that, we had considered the two planes which are mutually perpendicular to each other. For example, this one. And here we had considered that suppose this is the direction of the charge moving with velocity v, and this is the direction of the magnetic field which is lying in the horizontal plane, right? So you can look at this like this. If theta is the angle between the magnetic field, which is shown by blue scale here, and the direction of motion of the charge, which is shown by this marker here, right? Then the magnetic force will be perpendicular to the plane containing velocity and the magnetic field, and which is shown parallel to this perpendicular plane. So this diagram I had drawn on the board that day. So we will have to recall that. So if we look at this, this is the horizontal plane which I have shown by the horizontal plane of the book, right? And here, this is the perpendicular plane where force is acting. Now this I am showing the direction of velocity of this charged particle Q. This is the magnetic field direction. Then the direction of force is along this. Right? Where theta is the angle between the motion, the direction of the motion of the charge and the magnetic field. There we had discussed that we will have two components of this velocity. One component will be along theta. So you know that if we have a vector like this, and if we have to find the component along theta, then this component is a cos theta and the other component is a sine theta. Remember, similarly, here we have this velocity v along this direction. So this theta component along theta direction will be v cos theta. And the component along the perpendicular direction will be, this will be v sine theta. So we can say that this is the perpendicular component and this one is the parallel component. Parallel component means the component of velocity which is parallel to the magnetic field. Now let's take the formula for the magnetic force which we have already studied. This magnetic force is Q V cross B if we write in the vector form, right? And if we write the magnitude, so this magnitude will be Q V B sine theta. Here we can discuss the cases. Case 1. Case 1 is if theta, what is this theta? Here theta is the angle between V and B. This is angle between V and B. Right? So if theta is 0 degree, then what will be the force? The magnitude of the force will be Q V B sine of 0 degree. This makes it 0. So what's the result which we can infer from here? The first result for case 1 is that the force is zero if V is along B, right? What does that mean? By Newton's first law of motion, what is that? If external force is zero, then the body continues to remain in a state of rest or of uniform motion. So by Newton's first law of motion, the body, or yet the charge in this case, the charge will continue to move with same velocity along same direction. Along same direction. So what does it indicate? It indicates the linear motion. So this indicates linear motion, right? So let's take the case 2, which is also derived from the same formula. Now what can be the case 2? Case 2 we can consider as that when theta is 90, what does that mean? That means V is perpendicular to V, right? So let's check how much is the force acting then. Force is equal to QVB sine of 90 degree. This is the maximum force, right? So, but you can see that the force is perpendicular to the direction of velocity. What does that mean? When force is perpendicular to the direction of velocity, means force is perpendicular to displacement. So here we can say, therefore, F is perpendicular to velocity, means F is perpendicular to displacement, right? So therefore, when force is perpendicular to displacement, what will be the work done? Work done is equal to F S cos of 90 degree, that is zero. From this, if you look at the work energy theorem, what is that? The total work done by the net force is equal to the change in kinetic energy. So this work done by net force is equal to change in kinetic energy. So if work done is zero, therefore change in kinetic energy is also zero. So you can say that half m, or you can say that kinetic energy is constant. So therefore, kinetic energy is constant. So what does that mean? That means half m v square is equal to constant. So therefore, v is constant. What is v over here? It's the square. That means you can say that the speed is constant here, right? This much is clear. Now I'll draw the next diagram for explaining the case 2. Now look at this. Let's take this case that the charge is moving with velocity in this direction. We are saying that the velocity is perpendicular to the magnetic field. So we are considering that the magnetic field is entering this board perpendicular to it. So we are marking this magnetic field, because magnetic field by cross means magnetic field is inside the plane. Or you can say inward. Magnetic field perpendicularly inwards the plane. And dot means magnetic field perpendicularly outward the plane, right? So in this case, we know that the force is acting this way. So this force, if you look at this, now how we have found this direction, let's recall the Fleming's left hand rule. A, B, C. B is the magnetic field. This is the magnetic field. C is the direction of the velocity. And this is the force. Look, this is the magnetic field. This is the velocity. So the thumb is showing the force. So force is this way, right? This is by Fleming's left hand rule. Okay. So now you have to visualize a case. Suppose a person is moving this way with constant velocity and someone is constantly trying to pull him this way. There will be some effect on the change in direction. He himself is trying his hard to move the same way, but the other person is also trying to pull him this way only. He is standing here only. Okay. So this way, every next time he will try to move in the linear straight line, but this person will pull himself, first person towards the second person. So every next time the direction will slightly change. So this, as you can see here, this will result in a circular path. Similar case is happening over here, that this force is directed this way perpendicular to the motion. So every next time the direction of the particle is changing, right? So this way, if we look at this, this will result in a circular path, because at every point the force is directed towards a direction which is perpendicular to the velocity. So every place the force is this way. So this way. So this means, what is the result over here? The result over here is circular motion. So in this case, the charge will follow a circular path when B is perpendicular to V. Right? Is this much clear? And the speed along the path will remain the same, but the direction at every point will be different. So this was case 2. Now From here we can find out what will be the radius of this path and what will provide this circular motion. So here we know that this force is the magnetic force which is pulling the particle towards a particular point. So what is providing the circular motion, or you can say what is providing the centripetal force? You can say that the magnetic force provides the centripetal force. So, and that magnetic force is maximum, we have just derived, and that magnetic force is QVB, we derived in the previous slide. And if M is the mass of that particle, then this is the centripetal force. We know that the centripetal force is given by MV square upon R, where R is equal to radius of the circular path, right? So from here I can cancel this velocity, and R formula is MV upon QB, right? Very important formula. Now from here we can write this radius in another form also. This is V upon B into 1 upon Q upon M. This quantity Q upon M is called specific charge. This is called as charge to mass ratio. So for any charged particle, this radius of the path is inversely proportional to the specific charge, right? So this was our second case. Let's move on to the third case. So before we move to the third case, we must discuss about the time period of this circular path. What do we know by time period? What do we mean by time period? Time taken to complete one oscillation. So this is, or one revolution. Time taken to complete one revolution. So we know that speed is equal to distance upon time. So time period is distance upon speed, right? So this distance, because this is time period, so how much is the distance traveled in one revolution? So this distance will be, R is the radius, this distance will be 2 pi R upon V. So this time period can be calculated like this. We can put the value of R from the previous equation. So R is MV by QB. So here we can mention, since R is MV by QB. So from here, time period is 2 pi M by QB. You know what is frequency? Frequency is 1 upon time period. So this will be QB upon 2 pi M. These are very important relations which we have inferred from the case 2, right? Now let's take the case 3. So what is case 3? Case 3 will be the general case when the particle is obliquely moving with some angle with the magnetic field. So we know that this V parallel component is V cos theta and V perpendicular component is V sine theta. And we know that this is the direction of the force. We have already discussed this, right? Now from here, we know that when the velocity, the component of velocity which is parallel to magnetic field will result in linear motion as discussed in case 1. So this we are considering as case 3. We have two components of velocity, right? Two components of velocity, V parallel and V perpendicular. So V parallel will result in linear motion from case 2, case 1. Okay, and V perpendicular component will result in circular motion from case 2. So there will be a combination of linear and circular motion. Now look at this. Suppose this object, or you can say this charge, wants to move linearly this way, right? But there is a component of velocity which is trying to make it move in a circle. So what will happen in along with the circular movement, it will have some linear motion also. So this will result in a spiral motion, or you can say the helical motion. So this perpendicular velocity is moving it in the circle, okay, and the parallel velocity is resulting in straight line path, right? So result is helical path, helical motion, or you can say the helical path, which is a combination of the linear and the circular motions. Okay, so this is the helical path which is shown over here. Now from here we can find out pitch. We have studied what is pitch in class 11th. So here we will again define pitch. What is pitch? The linear distance traveled by a screw in one rotation. We have studied about screw gauge. There we have used the concept of pitch. We know that whenever we rotate a screw, it along with rotation moves forward, right? So this linear distance traveled in one rotation is called as pitch. So in this case, if we want to mark pitch, this is pitch. So which velocity is resulting in this linear motion? Because pitch is what? Linear distance. So if this is the linear distance, so which velocity is resulting it? Parallel component. So we can find out this by pitch is the linear distance, and we know that distance is equal to speed into time, right? So this distance is actually pitch, and this speed is which component? Parallel component, and time is time period, right? So this parallel component is v cos theta, time period is 2 pi m by q b, right? So here this is the formula for pitch. So we can rearrange it, 2 pi m v cos theta upon q b. This is pitch, right? So we have covered all the points related to the motion of a charged particle in uniform magnetic field. All these concepts will be useful when we will study the cyclotron. Hope you have understood these things well, right? So that's all for now. Thank you and have a nice day.